So now we're going to conclude this by looking at the last aspect, which is, what is the view from the wired world to all this mobility? And the short answer is, from the wired world perspective, mobility is completely transparent. That's a core behavior of the controllers. And let me explain to you how that works. I'll use a brown pen here. So you have a controller tunneled to an AP, and you have a wireless station. So notice that let's give the station an IP address IP1, and let's give it a MAC1. Now notice that even though the station is sending packets to the AP, the packets are going over a layer 2 or layer 3 tunnel to the controller. When they come northbound from the controller, there is a very important decision to make. Do the packets look like they're emanating from the controller, or do they look like they're emanating from the station? In other words, from the perspective of the backend network, is the controller a switch, a router, or a bridge? And the abstraction that we provide is that the controller is really a bridge. And this is very important because it's a key aspect of providing seamless mobility. So when the packets, let's say a particular packet from a station, goes out of the controller, it actually retains the source IP as well as the source MAC of that station. And this is a really important point, because if you have some server sitting on the backend network, it actually cannot tell that this particular device is connected over a layer 2 or layer 3 network, potentially somewhere around the world, potentially in a completely different subnet. As far as devices on this network are concerned, it looks as though that particular station was always connected to a port on this switch. And that's one of the unique capabilities of the controller. Thank you.